is an undertaking by the buyer's part to the exporter, giving assurance of payment when the shipment has been made, document compliance are presented, then of course payment is expected to be made. Meaning, shipment can be made, document presented, document are non-compliant, document are said to be discrepant because there are variance with the terms of the LC. For example, letter of credit says shipment must be done within social period. And we'll look at the example on the document we have very soon. And then shipment was not done within that period. So government said shipment must be done, letter shipment date 30th of June. And you present a document that said shipment was done 1st of July. Even though it's a one-day difference, that's a discrepant document. And that can affect payment. In fact, the buyer can refuse to even pick up document. Why? Discrepancy. So to the extent that it enhances, it gives security for payment, it also, to a guess what? It can also prevent you from getting paid at 20. Let's do that. How it runs, and then we look at the types, and then we examine the document in our hand. So, letter of credit is an irrevocable undertaking given by a bank, whereby it undertakes to honor a presentation of documents submitted in accordance with the terms and conditions of the LC. It is irrevocable, it's honored, it involves document, and terms and conditions must be met. It has different banks involved. The advising bank, the beneficiary's bank, the beneficiary is the exporter. The issuing bank, that's the importer's bank. The confirming bank. Now, I'll be talking about confirmation later on. Then the nominated bank, that's the bank at the exporter's country who is supposed to receive document from the exporter. Let's just look at a typical example. Look at how the letter of credit works. The payment is an undertaking, right? Now, being an undertaking, the implication is that a bank will not issue a letter of credit without protecting itself. So typically, the customer, the importer will fill an LC application form. Can you see? It provided the form to the bank and fill an LC application form. But provided a form. Now, the form can be in form of a loan, maybe as collateral, or it provides the cash itself. Then the importer's bank issued the LC. You know, because when I press sometimes, even though it appears, I think for this, let me just use this thing here so that we can follow it easily. So, provide the funds, fill the LC application form, the importer bank then issue the LC. Can we see it moving?
Yes.
Good. The exporter bank advise the LC to the exporter. The exporter then ship the goods, present documents. Present document to the exporter's to his bank. The document goes to the importer's bank. The importer bank already have money. The document is compliant. It effects the payment. Account of the exporter is credited already. Document is received to the importer who goes to the port and clears the goods. Do you notice something? There was no recourse to the importer at all. Why? The bank has the money. The bank has the money. And because the bank has the money, the bank already acting on behalf of the what? Of the importer. It's acting on his behalf. So it doesn't need to be cost to him again. Now, there's an issue with this transaction. Can anybody point it out? It's possible in this transaction that the exporter will not get paid, despite the issuing bank guarantee to pay. Can anybody tell me the reason why?